welcome you to 2020 Vision Chaka Khan TV. Okay? And stay tuned for the next installment. Happy Thanksgiving. Bye.
While I dance.
Thank you. Okay, so now we're back with What Am I Missing? This song is kind of spooky. It's rather dire. In the lyric as well, as I'm saying, something's going on tonight. There's an ill wind blowing. It's my spook song, but I love the song because it really speaks for the way I'm seeing society going today into a dark place. I see a lot of darkness in the light, if you can dig that. I see that all curtains are pulled back and we can see clearly pretty much who each other are, but we're seeing a lot of darkness. So that's what this song says to me. My brother and I wrote this song. We've been out actually partying all night. We were both living at my mom's house. Came back to my mom's and it was like 3 o'clock in the morning and couldn't get to sleep. So my brother, as he often did, bringing his bass, and he started playing a line and I would start singing to it. And this was after, you know, a night of debauchery and having fun. We came in and wrote this song. So enjoy.
Yeah. Thank you. honest and so tender.
First song I want to talk about with you is a song that I think was recorded in 78, and it's called Clouds. Now this song was written by Astrid and Simpson. I've talked about this song many times. What I didn't tell anybody was that Luther Vandross and Whitney Houston both sang background on this song as background singers, and they both made $60. Okay, so this song's history speaks for itself. I was almost going to tell you to Google it. Enjoy. beat wrong. Funny Valentine, which is a song that's older than dirt, or some might want to just call it a classic, and it is. Rodgers and Hart. You can't go wrong with a Rodgers and Hart song. What's special about this song is that Babyface produced it. My version of it. The one that you will be hearing right now. So enjoy.
Is it less than the reason?
This next song is one of my all-time favorites because I love the rhythm and the beat, not because it's sort of Eastern. Arif Martin, who was the producer, gave this song kind of an Eastern vibe. It's called Some Love. It was written by myself and my brother Mark Stevens. My brother came to me with this bass line and he had the chorus already written. And I just went on and wrote the lyrics to it. And so now we have some love. And just for your information, I'm going to start incorporating these B-sides to my all of my shows from here on out. Because I enjoy singing them so much.
Thank you.
for you diehards who would absolutely probably lynch me if I didn't do these songs. I'm putting them in the set for you. Okay? We did these on stage. I hope you enjoy all the beautiful effects that are going to take place and stuff like that. It's beautifully done, and I really enjoyed having the extra beauty all around me. It was like I was in an Alice in Wonder of Lands or something. Wonderland. Yes, Alice in Wonderland. It was fabulous. So now to the studio with the songs that I promised that you would get. Mwah. Happy Thanksgiving.
Captured after the slip, I saw it, it was happened so natural.
disarm every woman. Need I say more? Ashford and Simpson wrote the song. They sent me a demo of this song. Which sounded, if you heard the demo today, you wouldn't recognize the song. You know, demos are like that. You know, I have to take, when I used to take any demo I got from anybody and make it my own, which is not easy, but it's fun. So, Every Woman, an anthem song. It's a song of empowerment. And I like to have sing-alongs. The guys, when I sing the song on stage, everybody's singing it with me, even men. So I tell the men, I said, if you're straight, you can sing Climb Every Woman. And the women can sing I'm Every Woman. Now, I have not looked to see that distinction yet. But looked down. Just a little note. Something. Enjoy.